Okay, so this is a long-term strategic view that Hassan wants from you, Rajat. What do you think he should do with an HDI? I'll start accumulating it right now and build it up because I believe he has a longer-term. Okay, so we've got the management of Oberoi Realty addressing the media. Let's cut across.
And our annual results. The company has done well. It's been a challenging environment, but despite that, sales are robust and collections have been strong. There has been a flux in the DCR, which now stands clarified. We welcome the change. We also appreciate the fact that today there's a level playing field there, and so approvals have now started coming in fast and thick. So you will see a lot of construction happening as we go along. We continue to maintain a healthy balance sheet. On the back of that, you will see us continuing to look at attractive opportunities, and going forward we will do some large acquisitions over there. I'll now hand over to Somil Daru to take you through the details of the year that went by.
Thank you, Mr. Oberoi. To begin with, a few highlights. As far as the results are concerned, the revenue for FY12 stands at 975 crores. This is versus 1059 crores, which was the top line for FY11. The EBITDA for this year stands at 633 crores versus 640 crores, which was the EBITDA last year. EBITDA margin this year is at 65% versus the 61% which was the EBITDA margin last year for FY11. The profit before tax for FY12 stands at 606 crores versus 615 crores of last year, and the profit after tax number for this year stands at 463 crores versus the 517 crore number for last year. The revenues for the quarter. For Q4 FY12, the top line was 286 crores. This is vis-a-vis the Q3 FY12 number of 218 crores. The EBITDA for the Q4 this year was 195 crores versus the Q3 EBITDA of FY12 of 144 crores. The EBITDA margin for the quarter was at about 68%, which is an improvement over the EBITDA margin for Q3, which was at 66%. The profit before tax for this quarter stood at 188 crores versus 137 crores for Q3 FY12, and the profit after tax is at about 144 crores versus the 102 crores for Q3 FY12. Moving on to things other than just the numbers, the total sales volume for FY12 was at about 7 lakh square feet, which is almost the same as what was achieved in FY11. And the fact that there was no new launch in FY12. The total sales value which we did this year, this is purely from 7 lakh square feet of sales, was about 961 crores against the 914 odd crores which we did in FY11. This has obviously meant that there is a little higher realization per square feet also. The order book as of 31st March 2012 stands at about 1500 crores. This is vis-a-vis the 1100 crores of order book position which was in FY11. So again shows that despite the market conditions, we've been able to have the trust and the faith of the customers. Out of our ongoing projects, Oberoi Exquisite, which is at Goregaon, has crossed 1000 crores of sales in this year. And Oberoi Esquire has also crossed about 850 crores of sales. This is a cumulative number of project till date. Our total gross collections this year was at about 1100 crores. A small breakup of that, the residential projects collections was at about 885 crores. The rental incomes from the mall and the office spaces which we have leased out is about 130 crores. The hotel contributed a top line of about 90 crores. All in all, it has been a stable quarter and a stable year for us, and we are now open for any questions that you all may have.
Congrats. That's the management of Oberoi. Enumerating more on the numbers, a healthy balance sheet, looking at acquisitions, the EBITDA margin for FY12 at 65% vis-a-vis 61% and an order book at 1500. But let's quickly take it to Rajat Bose then.